Welcome to Veterans in Transition, where we promote the veteran community. Each week, we travel around the region highlighting veteran-related news, issues, and events. In this week's profile, we'll hear from a veteran who spent 3 years in a refugee camp. He joined the United States Navy, and his business model is designed to help veteran business owners and veterans seeking employment in the cyber and healthcare field. International correspondent Weedem Abdul has his story.
Tell us about your journey from Liberia to the United States and how that eventually led to your service in the U.S. military.
Looking back, my journey really, I would consider a rite of passage, personally for myself, because it was a long journey coming to the United States. It all started when there was a civil war, and I happened to be in boarding school at the time. And as a kid growing up, you don't think about war or tribal warfare. And I was cut in the middle as a child growing up. And so I was on campus. I do recall where my father sent the bodyguards to pick me up. And the purpose of that bodyguards coming to pick me up, it turned out that one of his bodyguard was killed in an ambush. And he realized that we were from the leading tribal group that was running the government, and our family would have been in danger. So he therefore sent the bodyguards to pick me up. And I recall again arriving at the house and realizing that my parents had already had everything packed up, and we were immediately forced to leave the country to go to a neighboring country in Sierra Leone as refugees. And we ended up living in refugee for 3 years, which I recall also just realizing how devastating things were. So my sibling and I ended up living in Sierra Leone for 3 years, where there were moments in time where we were told our parents were killed. And I also really felt just hopeless. Never would I ever have a future again. Don't have a parent and living as a refugee in a country where I was never born. Through the United States program for resettlement, I was fortunate to come to the U.S. as an immigrant with my family. There's over 11 of us, you know, 6 sisters and 4 brothers. And we came to the United States, and it was really cool that winter month, and we arrived in New York. I remember just getting a taste of the cold winter, and it was really cold, and we came in with just barely had any jackets or winter gear. But we were lucky. We were happy to be in the United States as immigrant. I went to middle school, and then I decided, I said, well, I have to somehow go on to college or I could join the military. And my father was a colonel, so I wanted to follow after his footsteps. And secondly, I felt like joining the U.S. Navy would have been a way of giving thanks to the United States for bringing my family to the U.S. So I joined the Navy. 1999, right after high school, I went to high school in Minneapolis, Minnesota. And I was stationed down Virginia Beach, where I had the opportunity to work in the F-18 squadron. And what's interesting about the Navy was that they put you as a plane captain, and I was in charge of an F-18 squadron jet. And so as a plane captain, I was responsible for aviation of that pilot life whenever he took off. And landing, I did all the QA inspection to make sure each component on the F-18 was safe enough for the pilot to fly. And so I went to school on the GI Bill. I got the associate degree in business and went on to University of Baltimore, where at the time I was so passionate about real estate, which I'm still am, but I went on and got a degree in real estate economic development thanks to the GI Bill. And after my college years, I decided to go on to pursue my career as an entrepreneur.
How has being a veteran prepared you for business?
Being a veteran prepared me for business in so many possible ways, in the sense that, number one, in the military, we have what, especially within the Navy, our Navy core value, honest, commitment, and integrity. Those core values are driving force and navigators that I was able to use as a guiding principles to go into business for myself.
How does your business serve veterans?
Our business model, as I mentioned, being a platform model, we have significant impact on the veteran community in various domain. And what I mean by domain is that we're number one able to integrate small business, veteran-owned company, and be able to bring them on board as partners, because Next Gen Cyber, our recruitment model is really based on building team. You know, there's no I in business. Business is really a contact sport. You can bring in partners to work together to compete. So by bringing in small business of veteran-owned businesses, and then also connecting with veteran community transitional program recruiters around the country, we are able to have massive impact on veteran community by offering them employment opportunity. And then on the educational side, we have Next Gen Cyber Academy, where we can then have veterans purchase courses for up to ethical hacking, Cisco certification. We have those courses online where they can freely take these courses and learn anywhere in the world, because it's all mobile, it's on the cloud-based courses. So that's kind of the impact we're able to have on the veteran community.
Share some words of wisdom for veterans who are contemplating entrepreneurship after service.
The one advice I'll give out there to the veteran community, if you're contemplating being an entrepreneur and going into business for yourself, there's a really good book I like to reference. It's called Outwitting the Devil by Napoleon Hill. He also wrote a book called Think and Grow Rich. And there was one passage I recall, and within that passage, there was a term called definiteness of purpose. And it's really about a burning desire within the individual. And that burning desire could be you having a kid in college, one have an opportunity to take care of your kids or family or loved ones, and using that as a burning desire to go into business. And by having that definiteness of purpose and having that burning desire, you can use those as a driving navigator to help you whenever you're going through a hard time and adversity. Because business is challenging, it is a contact sport. There will be days where you want to give up. And so by having those burning desire, you can use this as a driving force to keep pushing forward in life. So as a veteran, if you're looking to go into business, I would definitely advise you find what I call definiteness of purpose or burning desire.
What was your vision of America as a child in Liberia?
As a child in Liberia growing up and thinking of the United States, I just thought it was the land of opportunity. I mean, America has always been that country of beacon of hope and opportunity. And so growing up, we used to role play with my cousin, my siblings, of what is it like being in America? Imagine just living in a country where anything was possible. And I still believe today's America is the country of opportunity. Anything you dream is possible. And so as a child growing up, America was always that beacon of hope.